right, thanks for watching.
No, just kidding.
Wait, can I... Okay. Sup? It's Flowey. Flowey the flower? You're new to the underground, aren't you? Golly, you must be so confused.
Also, let me know how the audio balance turns out, because I've not streamed this before.
I mean, I know everything about Undertale, but I've not actually played it, so it'll be fun trying it. This little old me will have to do. Ready? Here we go. See that heart? Oh, there I am. That's your soul. The very culmination of your being. It starts off weak, but can grow strong if you gain a lot of LV. What's LV stand for? Why, love. You want some love, don't you? Alright, sure. Why not? Let's share it through. I don't know. I would very much like if you had, like, rainbow-colored friendliness pellets, or something, like, more plaid or striped. I mean, white seems pretty bland. Alright. Oh, I missed! Oh. Yeah, you're right. I missed. Okay. Right over there, just gonna catch it right there. Oh, I missed it. Run into the bullets. Friendliness pellets. Oh, whoa, those are moving a bit fast. Oh man, I missed them all. You know what's going on here, don't you? You just wanted to see me suffer. Die. Over here. Over here. Over. Oh. Oh, you missed. Somehow. What a terrible creature, torturing such a poor, innocent youth. Do not be afraid, my child. I am Toriel, caretaker of the ruins. I pass through this place every day to see if anyone has fallen down. You are the first human to come here in a long time. Come, I'll show you through the catacombs. This way. What if I want to go this way? Can I go this way? I want to just, like, see what's over here, if that's okay. Golden flowers. You must have broken your fall. Okay. Is there anything behind there? Suppose the game wants me to just follow the path. So I can do that. Welcome to your new home, innocent one. Allow me to educate you in the operation of the ruins. The ruins are full of puzzles. Ancient fusions between diversions and door keys. One must solve them to move from room to room. Please adjust yourself to the sight of them. To make progress here, you will need to trigger several switches. Do not worry, I have labeled the ones you need to flip. Actually, I'm curious, what's this say? Only the fearless may proceed. Brave ones, foolish ones, both walk not the middle road. Press Z to read signs. Stay on the path. What if I don't stay on the path? What if I... Okay, fine. Sup, Toriel? First switch is over on the wall. Oh, I see it. It's right over there. Okay, fine. Yeah. There's a switch here. Splendid! I am proud of you, little one. Let's move to the next room. Okay. That's cool. As a human living in the underground, monsters may attack you. You'll need to prepared for the situation. However, worry not. This process is simple. When you encounter a monster, you will enter a fight. While you are in a fight, strike up a friendly conversation. Stall for time. I will come to resolve the conflict. Practice talking to the dummy. Okay, we can talk to the dummy. I use an item. Nope. Let's see, let's run away. You ran away. Truthfully, that was not a poor choice. It is better to avoid conflict whenever possible. That, however, is only a dummy. It cannot harm you. It is made of cotton. It has no desire for revenge. Never mind. Stay close to me and I will keep you safe. There's another puzzle in this room. I wonder if you can solve it. Let's go. Frog, it attacks you. Alright, I use... let's see. What do I want to try? Froggit didn't understand what you said, but was flattered anyway. Ooh, Toriel's jealous. You won. Alright. The Western Room is the Eastern Room's blueprint. This is the puzzle, but... Here, take my hand for a moment. I could have solved that. Puzzles seem a little too dangerous for now. I don't know. They seem pretty safe here. See? Just, like, wander up and down and up and down. It's not that hard. You've done excellently thus far, my child. However, I have a difficult request to ask of you. I would like you to walk to the end of the room by yourself. Forgive me for this. Yep. Definitely a challenge. You can just smell the challenge. What if it's an unending room? Wouldn't that be a plot twist? Greetings, my child. Do not worry. I did not leave you. I was buried behind this pillar the whole time. Thank you for trusting me. However, there was an important reason for this exercise. To test your independence. I must attend to some business, and you must stay alone for a while. Please remain here. It's dangerous to explore by yourself. I have an idea. I will give you a cell phone. If you have a need for anything, just call. Be good, alright? Is there anything behind the pillar? How do I use the menu? That doesn't seem to be working. Oh, okay. I had no items, that's why I couldn't use item. This is Toriel. You only wanted to say hello? Well then, hello! I hope that suffices. This is Toriel. You want to say hello again? Salutations! Is that enough? This is Toriel. Are you bored? I should have given a book to you. My apologies. Why not use your imagination to divert yourself? Pretend you are a monarch. Rule over the leaf pile with a fist of iron. Can you do that for me? This is Toriel. Hello, my child. Sorry, I do not have much to say. It was nice to hear your voice, though. No, for my convenience, I'm using a controller. Mrs. Toriel, want to know more about me? Well, I'm afraid there's not much to say. I'm just a silly little lady who worries too much. No, look. Tell me more, come on. Mrs. Toriel? Huh? Did you just call me Mom? Well, I suppose. Would that make you happy? To call me Mother? Well then, call me whatever you like. Mrs. Toriel? Hello, my child. Okay. I get it. Oh. How adorable. I could pinch your cheek. You could certainly find better than an old woman like me. Oh dear, are you serious? And after you said you wanted to call me Mother, you are an interesting child. Mrs. Toriel. Okay. Fair enough. I call you again. I guess you're not gonna say anything. Oh. Well, now you call me. I've taken, like, one step. I just called you, like, 10 times in a row. And now you're calling me back. Okay. You've not left the room, have you? Seriously? There are a few puzzles ahead that I have yet to explain. It'd be dangerous for you to try them yourself. Be good, alright? Rabbit. Excuse me, human. I have some advice for you about battling monsters. If you act a certain way, or fight until you almost defeat them, they might not want to battle you anymore. If a monster does not want to fight you, please use some mercy, human. Rabbit. Says take one. Take a piece? Sure. Take one? Sure. You took more. How disgusting. Take one? Sure. You take another piece. You feel like the scum of the earth. Take one. Sure. You took too much too fast. The candy spills onto the floor. Look at what you've done. But I wanna take one. Can I take one? Please, can I take one? It told me to take one. I took one, and then told me to take one again. Well, so be it. Alright. I suppose playfully crinkling through the leaves fills you with determination. Yep, you got me, Kaz. Mrs. Toriel, for no reason in particular, which do you prefer? Cinnamon or butterscotch? Well, I don't know, this seems like a really important decision. Should I go with cinnamon? Or should I go with butterscotch? Ooh, we got one vote for cinnamon. I'm personally voting for butterscotch, so that's 1-1. And I guess the next vote breaks the tie. Team Butterscotch. Alright, here we go. Oh, I see. Thank you very much. Mrs. Toriel. Hello, my child. Sorry, I do not have much to say. Okay. Okay. Yeah, you could call me back, like, 1 second after I called you. You do not dislike cinnamon, do you? Actually, yeah, I hate cinnamon. It's the worst thing ever. I know what your preference is, but would you turn up your nose if I found cinnamon on your plate? Right. I understand. Thank you for being patient, by the way. 3 out of 4 gray rocks recommend you push them. Alright, we'll push them. That's 1. Crimson frinks out. Oh. Okay. Okay. I got 2 gold. 2 gold is better than no gold. Whee! This is where it is. Okay, so be it. Poor thing. Just always running. Didn't you read the sign downstairs? Nope! Did not read the... Oh. Maybe I should read the sign. Please don't step on the leaves. Moldsmold, block the way. Verbal. Oops, cancel. I got 1 gold. Go me. Didn't you read the sign downstairs? Yes, I did, and I'm ignoring it. No gold. Alright, let's push this bottom rock.
Whoa there, partner. Who said you could push me around?
Hmm? So you're asking me to move over?
Okay. Just for you, pumpkin. You want me to move some more? Alrighty, how's this?
Yeah. Great. Perfect.
That was the wrong direction. Alright, I think I got it.
Alright, yeah, just stay there and frog it, and Whimsen drew near. Hop. Battlefield is smelled with the smell of mustard. It's flattered anyway. Yeah, I got 2 gold.
Hey, stay on the pad, buddy. Giving me a real workout.
It's a workout to just stay there? Okay, sure. Knowing the mouse might one day leave its hole and get the cheese fills you with determination. Yeah, sure, let's save. It's been here quite a long time. It's stuck to the table. Oh no, it's a ghost. Z. Are they gone yet? Z. This ghost keeps saying Z out loud repeatedly, pretending to sleep. Move it with force? Eh, sure, why not? Here comes Napster Bloke. attack 10, defense 10. This doesn't seem to have a sense of humor. Oh, I'm real funny. Whoa. Oh, I missed that. I was wishing they weren't here. Okay. Give naps to Bloke a patient smile. Oh, that's quite the attack there. Looks just a little bit better. We told him a little joke. Heh, heh. Oops. Cheering seems to have improved his mood again. He wants to show you something. Let me try. I call it Dapper Luke. Do you like it? Well, that looks kind of cool. Come to the ruins because there's nobody around. But today I met somebody nice. Oh, I'm rambling again. I'll get out of your way. Did you miss it? Spider bake sale down and to the right. Come eat food made by spiders, for spiders, of spiders? Okay, sure, why not? Got a donut. Not hungry though. Ribbit, you're using F4 can make you have a full screen. But what does F4 stand for? Four frogs? I've only seen a maximum of 3 frogs in this room. It's troubling, to say the least. I've heard you're quite merciful for a human. Surely, you know by now, if a monster wears a yellow name, you can spare it. What do you think of that? Sure, it's helpful. It is rather helpful. Remember, sparing is just saying you won't fight. Maybe one day, you'll have to do it, even if their name isn't yellow. Hello? I just realized it's been a while since I've cleaned up. I was not expecting to have company so soon. There are probably a lot of things lying around here and there. You can pick them up, but do not carry more than you need. Someday, you might see something you really like. You will want to leave room in your pockets for that. Just one switch. Luke's drawn here. See, it's a pun on Latin, because there's the word Luke's in Latin, and never mind. You wouldn't get it. Finally, someone gets it. Don't kill me, buddy. I'm staring right through you. 5 gold. I'm curious, what's down here? Oh, there's Luke. Lukey, what you doing down here, buddy? Why are you hanging out down here? Ooh. Migos. Lala, just be yourself. Okay, sure. Easy peasy. I fell down a hole. Now I can't get up. Go on, without me. Wait, ghosts can fly, can't they? Oh well. Let's see. What Okay, glad to hear somebody gets it. Far door is not an exit. It simply marks a rotation in perspective. Luke's drawn here. Or drew near. Don't pick on him. Family name, Eyewalker. Oh, really? Really? So his name is Luke's Eyewalker. Okay. I can accept that. Telling me I gotta read the instructions. I suppose I should read the instructions. Nah. It's a switch. Sure, let's press it. You notice there's a blue switch behind the top pillar. A pair of vegetoids came out of the ground. You pat your stomach. Vegetoid offers a healthy meal. Whoa! Okay. Vegetoid B? I want some food. Your greens. Is that a Teletubby? Sure, why not? Alright, what does this say? If you can read this, press the red switch. More Vegetoids. It's a switch? Yeah, let's press it. Alright, what you telling me now? If you read this, press the green switch. It's a switch. Sure it is. Dear, that took longer than I thought it would. How did you get here, my child? Are you hurt? There, there, I will heal you. I should not have left you alone for so long. It was irresponsible to try to surprise you like this. Well, I suppose I cannot hide it any longer. Come, small one. Actually, I want to check out what's down here. Ribbit, just between you and me, I saw Toriel come out of here just a little while ago. She was carrying some groceries. I didn't ask what they were for. We're all too intimidated to talk to her. You found the toy knife. Such a cute, tidy house in the ruins gives you determination. I'm curious, how am I doing item-wise? I do have space left. Do you smell that? Surprise! It's a butterscotch cinnamon pie. I thought we might celebrate your arrival. I want you to have a nice time living here. So I'll hold off on snail pie for tonight. Here, I have another surprise for you. Okay. What is the surprise? I say as I go the opposite way. Hey look, it's a pie. Too hot to eat though. Stovetop is very clean. Toriel must use fire magic instead. Inside the cupboard, are cookie cutters for gingerbread monsters. There's some white fur stuck in the drain. For some reason, there's a brand name chocolate bar in the fridge. Seems like the right size for Toriel. The fire isn't burning hot, just pleasantly warm. You can put your hand inside. It's a history book. Here's a random page. Trapped behind the barrier and fearful of further human attacks, we retreated. Far, far into the earth we walked until we reached the cavern's end. That was our new home, which we named Home. As great as our king is, he's pretty lousy at names. The ends of the tools have been filed down to make them safer. Inside is an old calendar from the beginning of 21X. These books are worn. They must have been read many times. Okay. Hey, do not go down here. I have something to show you upstairs. Oh, fine, fine. Show me the thing. This is it. A room of your own. I hope you like it. Is something burning? Make yourself at home. You've seen this type of plant before, but do not know its name. It's you! Room under renovations. Flower seeds and broken crayons. It's Toriel's diary. Let's pass. It's an encyclopedia of subterranean plants you open to the middle. Typha. A group of wetland flowering plants with brown oblong seed pods, known more commonly as water sausages. Peek inside. Scandalous! It's Toriel's sock drawer. Definitely bigger than a twin size bed. Just a regular old bucket of snails. Oh, it's a water sausage. Empty photo frame. It's really dusty. Box of kids' shoes and disparity of sizes. Boop, 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 boop. Totally not getting in trouble. I think you should play upstairs instead. But there's so much fun stuff to do down here. It's dangerous to play here. I don't know. How dangerous can it really be? I mean, it's all worth it, right? It's drafty here. You'll catch a cold. And then we'll play some street countdown. I mean, it is dusty here. You will catch a cough. Okay, okay. Let's see. Only because you seem so insistent. Hello there, little one. The pie is not cooled down yet. Perhaps you should take a nap. You'd rather stay up and chat with me then. I want you to know how glad I am to have someone here. There's so many old books I want to share. I want to show you my favorite bug hunting spot. I've also prepared a curriculum for your education. This may come surprise to you, but I've always wanted to be a teacher. Shock! Actually, perhaps that isn't very surprising. Still, I'm glad you are living here. Oh, did you want something? What is it? Well, talk to me again if you need anything. Oh, I want to hear about the book I'm reading. It's called 72 Uses for Snails. How about it?
Yeah,
let's hear some snails. Here's an exciting snail fact. Actually, I can imagine Sheldon Cooper saying some of this. Here is an exciting snails fact. Did you know that snails make terrible shoelaces? Interesting.
Yeah.
Well, bother me again if you need anything else. What is it? If you need anything, just ask. I wanted some more snail facts. Can you not tell me about snails? I mean, it's great that they form terrible shoelaces, but can you not tell me more about them? Okay, fine. I have to do something. Stay here. Okay, but I'm gonna eat your entire pie. Fine. Well, while that's going on, let's go take a nap. Look at these cool toys. They don't interest you at all. Come on. I want the cool toys. Fine. So be it. So, Toriel. You wish to know how to return home, do you not? Ahead of us lies the end of the ruins, a one-way exit to the rest of the underground. I'm going to destroy it. No one will ever be able to leave again. Now be a good child and go upstairs. Okay. Well, thanks for watching. See you next time. Can I at least have some of the pie? I mean, you did make this pie, and I'm sure you're not intending to eat the whole thing. Okay, fine. If you're not going to give me the pie, I'm going to read your diary. You read the passage. Why did the skeleton want a friend? Because she was feeling bonely. The rest of the passage is filled with jokes of a similar caliber. Well, that's it. Okay. I was expecting more. It's just so unassuming. It's you. You sure it's me? You sure? I mean, who else would it be? You know, even if I go back and take a nap and all that, let's take another nap. Okay. Let's take a third nap. Fine. Yeah, I suppose we should eventually get on with the adventure, right? Every human that falls down here meets the same fate. I have seen it again and again. They come, they leave, they die. You naive child, if you leave the ruins, they, Asgore, will kill you. I am only protecting you, do you understand? Go to your room. Okay. Going to my room. Only because the game told me to. I better do it. Yep. So, let's see what's in the room. I went to the room. There's a little closet there I can't interact with. Empty photo frame I can't do anything with. Box of kids' shoes. toggle that if I want. A secret underground passage under the carpet. No, I mean, cool toys. Don't interest me at all. Alright, I went to the room. Hope Toriel's happy. Do not try to stop me. This is your final warning. You want to leave so badly? You're just like the others. There's only one solution to this. Prove yourself. Prove you're strong enough to survive. Toriel blocks the way. Attack 80, defense 80. Knows best for you. Toriel prepares a magical attack. Dude, Toriel, what's going on? I couldn't think of any conversation topics. I don't know, we could talk about snails. Toriel blocks, or looks through you. You tried to think of something to say again, but... Ooh, well that's special. Toriel looks through you. Ironically, talking does not seem to be the solution to this situation. Toriel is acting aloof. Toriel prepares a magical attack. Alright. What? Another magical attack. Toriel's acting aloof. Toriel prepares a magical attack. What are you doing? Attack or run away? Okay, you want me to attack? I'll attack. Who are you proving this way? Fight me or leave. Stop it. Stop looking at me that way. Go away. Toriel looks through. I know you want to go home, but please, go upstairs now. I promise I'll take good care of you here. I know we do not have much, but we can have a good life here. Why are you making this so difficult? Please, go upstairs. Huh. pathetic, is it not? I cannot save even a single child. No, I understand. You would just be unhappy, trapped down here. The ruins are very small once you get used to them. It would not be right for you to grow up in a place like this. My expectations, my loneliness, my fear, for you, my child, I will put them aside. If you truly wish to leave the ruins, I will not stop you. However, when you leave, please do not come back. I hope you understand. Goodbye, my child. I want the pie. Can I have the pie, please? Please? I want some pie. You made this entire pie and you did not even share it with me. You told me how great it would be. How well she would care for me. And, I mean, has it cooled down yet? What a nice smell. Too hot to eat, though. Okay. I'll make my own pie if I have to. Please, wake up. You are the future of humans and monsters. Okay, fine. So, where's Toriel hiding? And can I please have some pie? Please. There's some white fur stuck in the drain. Well, I guess that means no pie for me. I mean, you told me how dangerous and risky it was for you to go ahead and trust me to make my way through the ruins. Just so you can make this pie for me and try to surprise me. And you did surprise me with a cinnamon butterscotch pie, and then you didn't even give me it. I mean, that's just not right. Clever. Very clever. You think you're really smart, don't you? In this world, it's kill or be killed. So, you were able to play by your own rules. You spared the life of a single person. I bet you feel really great. You didn't kill anybody this time. But what will you do if you meet a relentless killer? You'll die. And you'll die, and you'll die. Until you tire of trying. What will you do then? Will you kill out of frustration? Or will you give up entirely on this world? And let me inherit the power to control it. I am the prince of this world's future. Don't worry, my little monarch. My plan is not regicide. This is so much more interesting. Tough words for a dandelion. Or a golden flower. Ooh, what's this? There's a camera hidden in the bushes. Alright, can I go back there? Nope. Alright, we're gonna go in the foreground then. Being careful to stay off the path. Just because why not? Man, there's a lot of trees here. So many trees. Okay, fine. Let's cross. Human, don't you know how to greet a new pal? Turn around and shake my hand.
The old whoopee cushion in the hand trick. Always funny. Anyway, you're human, right? That's hilarious. I'm sad as the skeleton. I'm just supposed to be on watch for humans right now. But, you know, I don't really care about capturing anybody. My brother, Papyrus, he's a human hunting fanatic. Actually, I think that's him over there. I have an idea. Go through this gate thingy. Yeah, go right through. The bro made the bars too wide to stop anyone. Quick, find the conveniently shaped lamp. Okay, sure, why not? So, bro.
You know what's up, brother. It's been 8 days and you still haven't recalibrated your puzzles. Just hang around outside your station. What are you even doing?
Staring at this lamp. It's really cool. You wanna look?
No! I don't have time for that. What if a human comes through here? I have to be ready. To be the one, I must be the one, I will capture a human. Then I, the great Papyrus, will get all the things I utterly deserve, respect, recognition. I will finally be able to join the royal guard. People ask to be my friend. I'll bathe in a shower of kisses every morning.
Maybe this lamp will help you.
Sans, you are not helping, you lazy bones. All you will do is sit and boondoggle, lazier every day.
Take it easy. I've got a ton of work done today. A skeleton.
Sans?
Come on, you're smiling.
Oh, and I hate it. Why does someone as great as me have to do so much just to get some recognition?
Wow, sounds like you're really working yourself to the bone.
Tend to my puzzles just for your work. Put a little more backbone into it.
Trying to have some fun with it. Alright. Come out. Don't know that I'd do that for all the characters, but these guys are pretty cool.
You'll get going. You might come back. If he does, you'll have to sit through more of my hilarious jokes.
Nothing to be afraid of, it's just a dark cavern filled with skeletons and horrible monsters. Well, gotta get going, you might come back, and if he does, yeah, okay. Just a conveniently shaped lamp. Are we sure? I don't know. I have theories about that lamp. Some kind of checkpoint or sentry station, but there's ketchup, mustard, and relish sitting inside. Man. I don't know, I could go for like a hot dog or something.
Actually, hate to bother you, but could you do me a favor? I was thinking, my brother's kinda down lately. He's never seen a human. See, you just might make his day. Don't worry, he's not dangerous. Even if he tries to be. Thanks, I'll be up ahead.
Thank you. Snowdrake. Teen comedian. Fights to keep a captive audience. Man. He tells some pretty sick jokes, eh? He's pleased with his cool joke. Yeah, I got money for him telling jokes. How does that work? Fishing rod affixed to the ground. Sure, let's reel it in. A photo of a weird-looking monster. Call me, here's my number. Truly, there are plenty of fish in the sea. You decide not to call. What if I want to call? You send the line back out. So sing about Undyne. Well, these guys.
Actually, I think that's a rock.
Oh.
Hey, is that in front of the rock?
Oh! Is that a human?
Yes.
Oh my god! Finally did! I'm dying! Well, I'm gonna be so popular! Human! You shall not pass this area! I, the great papyrus, will stop you! I'll then capture you. You will be delivered to the capital. Then, I'm not sure what happens next. In any case, continue only if you dare.
Well, that went well. Don't sweat it. I'll keep an eye socket out for you.
Oh, okay. Sure. Sounds safe enough. Ice Camp struts into view. Wonders why it isn't named Ice Hat. Snow? It's hat residue. He's thinking about a certain article of clothing. You may should tire your eyes away from Ice Cap's hat. It looks annoyed. Hello? My hat's up here. Secretly checking if you're looking at its hat. You continue, not looking at Ice Cap's hat. Seems defeated. Okay, I'll ignore you too. It's desperate for attention. You inform it that it has a great hat. It's too loud for me to hear you. Tried to steal Ice Cap's hat, and succeeded. It melts in your hands. What can I say? Ice Cap is no more. You inform it that it still looks fine. It doesn't mind its identity. Hats are for posers. Yeah, I like my hair, too. $35 gold. There's some narration on the cardboard box.
You observe?
You observe the well-crafted sentry station. Who could have built this, you wonder? I bet it was that very famous royal guardsman.
Note,
not very, a very famous royal guardsman.
There's a camera behind the sentry station. Okay. Yeah, we read that. I wonder who could have written that narration. Absolutely no moving. Oh, okay. No moving. Well, I suppose, you know, I should think about moving, maybe? Okay, let's move. Did something move? Was it my imagination? I can only see moving things. If something was moving, for example, a human, I'll make sure it never moves again. Doggo blocks the way. Attack 13, defense 7, easily excited by movement. Hobbies include squirrels. Don't move an inch. Doggo can't seem to find anything. You pet Doggo. What? I've been pet! He's been pet. Let's pet him again. He keeps saying pet and pot. All the stuff. 30 gold. Something pet me, something that's not moving. I'm gonna need some dog treats for this. Is anybody there? Nope. Someone's been smoking dog treats. Way to blaze it.
Hey! There's something important to remember. My brother has a very special attack. If you see a blue attack, don't move and it won't hurt you. Here's an easy way to keep it in mind. Imagine a stop sign. When you see a stop sign, you stop, right? Stop signs are red, so imagine a blue stop sign instead. Simple, right? In fighting, think about yellow, blue, red, blue, purple, green, blue stop signs. That makes sense. North, ice. South, ice. West, ice. East, snowed in town, and ice. Alright, let's go north.
What's up? I'm a snowman. I want to see the world, but I can't move. Be so kind, traveler. Please take a piece of me and take it very far away.
Sure, why not?
Thank you, good luck.
Snow piece.
Nope, I hear those things are edible.
You're so lazy. You're napping all night.
I think that's called sleeping.
Excuses, excuses. Oh no, the human arrives. In order to stop you, my brother and I have created some bubbles. I think you'll find this one quite shocking. For you see, this is the invisible electricity maze. Touch the walls of this maze before we'll administer Hachizaku. Sound like fun? Because the amount of fun you'll probably have is actually rather small, I think. Okay, you can go ahead now. Come on, don't be so rude. This puzzle's just for you. Do you treat your mother this way when she makes you a puzzle? Humans. Okay, fine.
Do
you do?
I think the human has to hold you up.
Oh, okay. Put this. Okay, try now.
Man, this is a pretty tough puzzle.
Incredible! You slippery snail! Solved it so easily, too easily! However, the next puzzle will not be so easy. It's designed by my brother. Sans, you will surely be confounded. I know I am. Yeah.
Hey, thanks. My brother seems like he's having fun. By the way, did you see the weird outfit he's wearing? He did that a few weeks ago for a costume party. He hasn't worn anything else since. He keeps calling it his battle body. Man, isn't my brother cool?
Don't understand why they're not selling. It's the perfect weather condition for something cold.
Oh, a customer! Would you like some ice cream? It's the frozen treat that warms your heart. Now just 15G. Sure, we'll take one. You got the ice cream.
Actually, I think I'll pass.
Tell your friends, there's ice cream out in the middle of the woods. Oops. Kick, 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 kick.
Purple. Even when you felt trapped, you took notes and achieved the end of ball. You're awarded 2G. Green, your concern and care for Ball led you to a delicious victory. And you're awarded 1G.
Man. If only this game were as easy as Locke's Ball.
I get a G again? Yeah. Just raking in all the G's.
I wonder if this might be easier with a keyboard.
There we go. Your surefire accuracy put an end to the mayhem of ball. You're awarded 3G.
Thinking about selling treats too. Want some fried snow? It's just 5G. Did I say 5? I meant 50. Really? How about 5,000? 50,000, that's my final offer. You don't have the money? Hey, that's okay. I don't have any snow.
Smell danger rating. Snow smell, snowman, white rating, can become yellow rating. Unsuspicious smell, puppy, blue rating, smell of rolling around. Weird smell, humans, red rating, green rating, destroy at all costs. Hers is. Looks like a snowball. Actually, it's a snow decahedron.
Human, I hope you're ready. Science, where's the puzzle?
It's right there, on the ground. Trust me, there's no way they can get past this one. Alright, here we are.
Hey kids, can you help me solve this puzzle?
Well, let's see how many of these we can find.
Alright, so where's Fall? Fall's gotta be here somewhere, right? Oh, I see it. Okay, how about Winter? Okay, I see Winter. Spring? Oh, there it is. Summer? It's gotta be here somewhere. Where is Summer? Oh, I see it. There's Summer. Monster. There it is. Skeletons? Yep. Mermaid. Yep. Robot. Yep. Cigars? Where's Cigars? Oh, there it is. Cig? Well, it's part of Cigars, so there it is. But Hot? Found Hot. And how about Gias Filibrever? Yep, I admit to being a bit stumped on that one. Oh well. No, I get it. But, yeah, it's not there.
Sans! That didn't do anything!
Whoops. I knew I should have used today's crossword instead.
What? Crossword? I can't believe you said that! In my opinion, Junior Jumble's easily the hardest.
What? Really, dude? That easy-peasy word scramble, that's for baby bones.
Unbelievable. Human solves the dispute.
Well, obviously crosswords are way harder.
You two are weird. Crosswords are so easy. It's the same solution every time. I just fill in all the boxes with the letter Z. Because every time I look at a crossword, all I can do is snore. Yeah.
Honestly, it's probably a good way to address crosswords if you're not devoted to them. Papyrus finds difficulty in interesting places.
Yesterday, he got stumped trying to solve the horoscope.
Yeah, but, I mean, this is another interesting place to find difficulty. I mean, you were saying that we couldn't get past this one. For sure. And you know, I mean, technically you're right, we didn't manage to solve this, but just walk past it. It's a note from Papyrus.
Human, please enjoy the spaghetti. Little do you know, this spaghetti is a trap, designed to entice you. You'll be so busy eating it that you won't realize you aren't progressing. Thoroughly japed again by the great Papyrus. Yeah, Papyrus.
Knowing the mouse might one day find a way to heat up the spaghetti, it fills you with determination. Sure. Warning, dog marriage. Yes, you read that correctly. Lesser dog appears. Man, that's a cool looking shield there. Oh. Oh, it's colored sprites mod. Definitely brings some things to life here. I did not recognize that until just now. But man, that looks pretty cool. Oh, let's check. Lesser dog. Tech 12, Defense 2. Wields a stone dagger made of Palmer granite. Hint, hint. Whoa! Careful there. Cocks its head to one side. You barely lifted your hand, and the lesser dog got excited. Tiny bark. Whoa. It's barking excitingly. Excitedly. You lightly touch the dog. It's already overexcited. It's barking excitedly. It raises its head up to meet your hand. Can't pant. Let's pet it again. It was a good dog. Ouch. You pet the dog, its excitement knows no bounds. Dang, it's gonna kill me. You're the monster king. Don't kill me, bro. Please? Oops. Wrong menu. Critical pet. Dog excitement increased. You have to jump up to pet the dog. You don't even pet it. It gets more excited. There is no way to stop this madness. It enters the realm of the clouds. Call the dog, but it's too late. It cannot hear you. You cannot reach Lesser Dog, or you can reach Lesser Dog again. Pet Lesser Dog. Pet it. Pant, pant. It's lowering. Possible you might have a problem. Hello there. Perhaps mankind was not meant to pet this much. Continues. Beyond your reach. Really? Hmm. curious, how far can I take this? I think that's as far as it goes. 60 gold. There's a switch hidden in the snow. That smell? Where's that smell? If you're a smell, identify yourself. Here's that weird smell. Makes me want to eliminate. Eliminate you! Dog-eye assault you. Or dodgy. Husband of Dogaressa. Knows only what he smells. Let's kick human tail. Do humans have tails? Dogs are practicing for the next couples contest. You roll around in the dirt and snow. Take my wife's fleas. Dogs may want to re-smell you. You smell alright? Smells? Are you a puppy? Dogs think you may be a lost puppy. You pet dog of me. Wow, pet by another pup. Don't leave me out. Wow, they really like being pet, that's for sure. The dog's minds have been expanded. $40 gold, oh yeah. Dogs can pet other dogs? The world has opened up for us. Thanks, weird puppy. Avoid my trap, and more importantly, is there any left for me? What do you tell Papyrus about a spaghetti? Yeah, I actually don't like spaghetti, so... Really? Wowie! You resisted the flavor of my home-cooked pasta just so you could share it with me. Fret not, human. My master chef Papyrus will make you all the pasta you could ever want. Yeah. Brother started a sock collection recently. How saddening. Sometimes I wonder what he would do without such a cool guy taking care of him. Yeah. Human. How do I say this? You were taking a long time to arrive, so I decided to improve this puzzle by arranging the snow to look more like my face. Unfortunately, the snow froze to the ground. Now the solution is different, and as usual, my lazy brother's nowhere around. I suppose what I'm saying is, worry not, human. I, the great Papyrus, will solve this conundrum. Then we can both proceed. Meanwhile, feel free to try the puzzle yourself. Try not to give away the answer. Okay. Let's hit this dude. And let's do some of this, some of that, some of that, a little bit of this, a little bit of that.
Wow, you solved it! You did it all without my help! Incredible, I'm impressed! You must care about puzzles like I do. Well, I'm sure you'll love the next puzzle then. might be even too easy for you. Come on, just show me the puzzle. Give me a real puzzle.
Good job in solving it so quickly. You didn't even need my help. Which is great. Because I love doing absolutely nothing.
Hey! It's the human! You're gonna love this puzzle. It was made by the great Dr. Elfies. You see these tiles? Once I throw the switch, they will begin to change color. Each color has a different function. Red tiles are impassable. You cannot walk on them. Yellow tiles are electric. They will electrocute you. Green tiles are lamb tiles. If you step on them, you will have to fight a monster. Orange tiles are orange scented. They will make you smell delicious. Blue tiles are water tiles. Swim through if you like. But if you smell like oranges, the piranhas will bite you. Also, if a blue tile is next to a yellow tile, the water will zap you. Purple tiles are slippery. You will slide to the next tile. However, the slippery soap smells like lemons, which piranhas do not like. Purple and blue are okay. Finally, pink tiles. They don't do anything. Step on them all you like. How was that? Understand?
Let's do that one more time.
Okay, I guess I'll repeat myself. Red tiles are impassable. Yellow tiles are electric and dangerous. Blue tiles make you fight a monster. Green tiles are water tiles. Orange tiles are orange scented. If you step on orange, don't step on green. Brown tiles are... Wait. There are no brown tiles. Purple tiles smell like lemons? Why don't the yellow ones smell lemony? Wait. Did I mix up green and blue? The blue ones are water ones. Pink tiles. I don't remember. Wait. Those ones don't do anything. Okay. Do you understand better now?
Great explanation. Yeah, let's do this.
Great. There's one last thing. This puzzle is entirely random. When I pull the switch, it will make a puzzle that has never been seen before. Not even I will know the solution. Get ready.
All right.
Bam!
There it is. Well, I don't know. This one looks pretty tricky. I mean, compared to that word search, and compared to that spaghetti, I don't know. This one seems like the trickiest one of them all. Let's see. So the upper left corner is red, so we can't step on that. The one next to that's also red, so we can't step there either. Let's try a different approach. What if I just hold right? There we go. Machine's not working. That's a pity.
Actually, spaghetti from earlier. Wasn't too bad for my brother. Since he started cooking lessons, he's been improving a lot. But if he keeps it up, next year he'll even make something edible.
Aw, look! It's a snow lesser dog. At least somebody attempting to make one. Aware of dog? Please, pet dog. On the floor inside is a box of pomeraisins. Knowing this dog will never give up trying to make the perfect snow dog fills you with determination. What does this fellow have to say? A dog just rushed in here, filled with inspiration. Kept trying to build a snow dog that expressed its own emotions. But as it built, it kept getting more excited about the sculpture. Its neck got longer and longer and has added more and more snow until, well, it was rather sad to watch. But I couldn't turn away. Oops. Let's try this again. Oops, I misstepped yet again. Actually, what's down here? It's a snow papyrus. Clearly, a lot more effort was put into the snow papyrus than was put into the snow sands.
But hey, whatever floats your boat, right?
Say, you following me?
Gift Trot confronts you. Gift Trot, some teens decorate it as a prank.
Is this funny to you?
Or maybe it's Gift Rot. It laments its lack of hands. You remove the lenticular bookmark of a smug teen winking. That's a little better. Whoa, whoa, whoa. You remove a small, confused dog. Remove the box of non-related dog ravens. Weight has been lifted. Try to undecorate?
Those are real. Say, following me? You sure do like to exercise. Are you lost? You sure do like to exercise. Okay. Fine.
It's a snowpuff? Guys, I found a snowpuff. And I found a snowpuff. Look, it's a snowpuff. Woof. Another snowpuff. It's a snowpuff. Behold, a snowpuff. There's 30G. Inside this. What's this?
Hey, guess what this is?
Bet you're thinking it's a snowplow, right?
It's the greater dog.
Attack 15. Excited, the thing's fighting is just play. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa! It's not excited enough to play with. Whoops, that was dumb. It's too far away to pet. You just pet the air. With that, it's perhaps time for a break. There's many lines, as many characters, much still left to enjoy. Been going for quite a while, so pick this up next time. Take care and have a good night.